What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Imagine a busy schedule with various activities, each represented by intervals on a timeline. Given the schedule, the aim of today's question is to maximize the number of activities we can do such that none overlap with another. In other words, we must return the minimum number of intervals we need to remove to make the rest of the intervals non-overlapping. As an example, take these intervals. If we try to place them on a timeline, we can clearly see that the interval in purple overlaps with the others, and removing it will allow us to keep all other intervals. So, the answer in this example is 1. By removing one interval, the rest will become non-overlapping. The brute force approach associated with this problem is to generate the possible combinations of all the intervals and count the number of intervals to be removed from each combination. So, to visualize this, take an array of the previous intervals we had as an example. The combinations associated with these intervals can be seen in front of us. After fetching all the combinations, we need to check among the ones that do not contain overlapping intervals which one contains the maximum number of intervals. What you see is a potential, yet non-complete implementation of this approach. This implementation has an exponential time complexity of big O of 2 to the power n, n being the number of intervals, and surely that is not what the interviewers are looking for. You see, when it comes to intervals, and in 90% of the problems involving intervals, always keep in mind sorting the intervals by either their lower or upper bound. Sorting by upper bound, which in this case represents the n times of the activity, is a common strategy in interval-related problems. This ensures that intervals with earlier n times come first in the sorted array. Take the same array of intervals we had as an example. Let's start by sorting the intervals based on their n times in ascending order. While iterating through the intervals, all we need to check now are adjacent values, since if a potential overlap exists, then it must be between adjacent intervals. If the start time of an interval is smaller than the end time of the one preceding it, it means there is an overlap and that interval needs to be removed. To implement this solution, we start by sorting the intervals using their upper bound. Then we iterate through the sorted intervals, starting from the second one. Next is checking for overlaps. So, as we mentioned, if the start time of the current interval is less than the end time of the previous interval, it means there is an overlap and the current interval needs to be removed. If not, we move on to the next interval in the array. After traversing all the intervals, the total number of removed intervals is returned. This implementation takes advantage of sorting by end times and efficiently identifies overlapping intervals. The time complexity is dominated by the sorting step, making it O of n log n, where n is the number of intervals. This is a big improvement on the exponential brute force approach. But why did we choose to sort by the upper bound and not lower bound? When should we make use of each? Well, we didn't have to sort by end times, we could have sorted by start times as well, but it just seemed more intuitive. Here is the modified version of the previous implementation that sorts by start times. As we can see, it is fairly similar to the previous one. The main difference is while moving from one pair of intervals to another, we need to take into consideration that the end time of the interval we are at might not be the one we'll use in the next iteration. And that's what makes sorting by end times in this case more intuitive and natural. This type of intervals problem falls under the scheduling category. What do I mean by that? You see, there are mainly two types of interval problems, the ones that fit into interval partitioning and the one that fit into interval scheduling. Every interval problem can be thought of as processes having a certain running time, which is their interval, and that interval needs to be scheduled or partitioned and distributed to use available resources. In interval partitioning, we need to keep track of which processes are currently running, or else we don't know which resources are free and won't be able to allocate them effectively. So, we need to know when each process starts to be able to account for that. Hence, sorting by start time would be more natural and intuitive in that case. On the other hand, for interval scheduling, we don't necessarily need to monitor which processes are currently running. When a process finishes, we can easily check whether the resource is available or not. And if it is, then we can allocate it to a new process. In this case, sorting by end times seems to be more natural and intuitive. Let us know in the comments below if you'd like us to solve more interval problems. And that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.